Developments tonight in the starvation death of a child whose body was found in a suitcase. Baltimore police arrested the child's mother. 11 News reporter John Sherman is live at City Police headquarters. He has details for us. John?
Well, Rod, this is a tragedy the accused killer's mother insists would never have happened if it hadn't been for the One Mind Ministries, a cult she argues is still brainwashing her daughter.
You're talking about 2.5 years of brainwashing. You know, she didn't stop calling me her mother. She called me by her name. She just own. This is what they make her do. You know, you can't talk to people on the outside. You got to stay away from those people. They were her family. We wasn't her family no more. We were the bad people.
Sita Newton says her daughter, 21-year-old Rhea Ram Kassoon, was swept away by the faith-based religious cult One Mind Ministries. She says 2 years of letters she wrote were intercepted. She only found that out yesterday.
I mean, I used to write my daughter letters every week. I would send her a letter. She told me yesterday, I said, Rhea, I used to write you all these letters. Your brother needed you. She said she never got them. And I believe it.
Charging documents outlining the state's case against Ram Kassoon, a.k.a. Princess Marie, show the shocking nature of the tragedy. Ram Kassoon, seen here, went to live with the cult first in Baltimore, then in Philadelphia. Her son, Javon, named by the cult Prince Josiah, wasn't even three when he was labeled a demon by the cult. Why? He wouldn't say amen after eating. As punishment, they deprived the toddler of all food and water until one day he stopped breathing and died. They sought no medical attention, and cult leader Queen Antoinette ordered his body put in a green suitcase.
Do you believe she's innocent of what they say she did?
I don't think Rhea made the decision to starve her son. Rhea wasn't the one making the call. Rhea wasn't the one in control. They was going by orders. And the leader of the cult and her daughter, they were the two that was making the decisions.
Mrs. Newton says she repeatedly called social services and the police to try to get help for her grandson, but she says she was told it wasn't her concern because the child was in the care of his adult mother. Live downtown, John Sherman, WBAL-TV 11 News.